So that what is the situation in Australia now as you see it? What can these agencies get exactly, and what are they getting that we don't know about, if anything?
So that's a good question. So what we know that they can access is that a set of these known agencies, and I think that figure of 330,000 accesses to what we won't call metadata, is not including ASIO.
ASIO, that's correct.
Okay? Not including ASIO. So we don't know how many accesses ASIO or the other intelligence agencies have done. But they can at the moment say to an ISP, we'd like you to put a preservation notice on Joe Blow's data because we think that he's involved in a crime. And then that will be preserved for a couple of months. And they can come back then with a warrant, as you might do in a criminal investigation, to get access to the actual communications. That's a very reasonable way of doing it. It's very targeted, very narrow in scope. It's really intruding in someone's life where there is probable cause, and an oversight body, a judge, has presumably signed off on that warrant. That's quite fair.
That's the warrant for the content.
That's the warrant for the content, but not for the metadata. Exactly, exactly. But presumably you would go down a path of saying, would you issue this preservation notice with a view to investigate? Maybe what you find on the preservation notice, you know, retention that's done, that person really isn't a person of interest after all. Okay, we don't need to get a warrant. We're not interested in pursuing them. The much more concerning thing is to understand how all-pervasive the intelligence agency's invasion of our privacy is. And we don't know that from the formal reporting that they've done to Parliament, because they haven't. What we know it from is people like Edward Snowden's revelations. So the kind of things we know about that, which are really a few data points and not so much Australia-specific. There's a bit around Australia, but more internationally based. They present individually only a glimpse, but together they provide a pretty big picture. And I would hypothesize, based on the Snowden revelations, that there probably is some degree of automated wide-scale monitoring of most electronic communications in and out of Australia. And I would hypothesize domestically as well. Now, those might not be some guy in a room reading everybody's email as it passes through the system. That would, you know, be automated. But we also know, somewhat more disturbingly, aside from that passive potential collection that I would suggest is probably out there, is a more active approach. So we saw a revelation from the Snowden revelations of the U.S. National Security Agency creating or planning to create malware that wouldn't just target a couple of hundred terrorists' computers to get information about a terrorist strike, but potentially a million or more computers. And that might involve entire networks of computers. Now, they didn't say a financial institution, for example, a bank, but you could hypothesize that they might be going after a bunch of financial records for an entire population of people. Well, why is that important? Because the minute you write a piece of malware and you insert it into a million computers, particularly connected with a bank, for example, you've just created a giant security hole that any criminal who discovers it can walk through. But more importantly, you've done something much more damaging to society. Our society depends on trust in our institutions, not just trust in government, trust in the financial institutions, online transactions, B2B, B2C, all of that. You have potentially broken the nexus of that trust. And I am astonished that the business community, and particularly the financial services community that potentially has the most to lose from breaking of trust, is not absolutely up in arms about this. Because they have spent so much time and money and resources carefully building this customer trust for online financial transactions. And now, with just a little intervention by government, it could all come crumbling down.